Hi everyone, welcome you all. In today's video, let us try to understand tagging concept in Playwright. So Playwright is provided different type of annotations, and along with annotations, which is also provided different type of tags and the concept we can use. And first of all, let us try to understand the tagging concept, and then we will discuss about annotations in the next video. So what is a tagging? So basically, whenever you are writing the multiple test, right? So by default, all the tests will be executed. So if you want to execute the test by using some tag, or suppose you want to group the test by passing by specifying some tag, and then we can use this tagging concept. So this is simple documentation they have provided, and let us see practically how can we use this tagging concept. So for that, I'm opening my VS Code editor, and I already created one spec file, tags.spec.js. Now in this, I'm going to write some simple test and importing some package. And I'm writing some simple test block. I can say test. Now my test name is test1. And then I can write async. And inside this, I'm passing page fixture, and then write arrow function. Okay, the simple test, I'm writing simple console message. I'm not going to write any test script. I can say console.log, and this is my test one. Okay, so similarly, I'm trying to write some more test. You can say this is my test one, it's a test two, test three, four, and five. So five different type of tests. Let me change the names. This is my test two, and this is my, let's say, test three, and this is my test four, and then the last one, this is my test five. So totally five tests I have created in my file. So let me save it, and when you run the file, when you run the test, so normally what you will do is npx playwright test, and here you can specify the name of the file. So the name of the file is what? Tags.spec.js. So when I execute this command, so by default, all the tests will be executed. You can just look at here. All my five tests are successfully executed and passed. Okay, now what I will do is I will just add some tags for every test. Suppose, let us assume test one and test two belongs to sanity, and test two, test four all belongs to regression, and test five belongs to both sanity and regression. So like this, we can divide the test into multiple groups or multiple categories. Okay, so for that, what I will do is I will just add something tag, and where we can add the tag here is along with the test description. Okay, so here test one, so I'm adding some tag in this. I can say I'll make it, this is a part of sanity. So whenever you provide the tag, you can just use @ symbol. So this is a tag, and you can put the tag in before the test also. Here also you can put nothing wrong. Okay, so you can just put this sanity, but if you put like this, you should not specify anything after that name of the tag. Okay, so always better to specify this one, test one @ sanity. So this is the tag I have provided to the test one, and I will also consider test two is a sanity, so I can just specify @ sanity. Now test three is a part of regression, so for example, I say regression. Okay, simple name, I say reg. And test four also, I'll make it as a regression, and tag is added. And now test five belongs to both the tags. I can say @ sanity and also @ regression. Like this, you can specify multiple tags for one test. So once you specified the tags, now there are two sanities and two regression tests, and one is belongs to both sanity and regression, right? Now, when I execute the test again, by default, all the tests will be executed. But now my requirement is I want to execute only the test which are specified sanity tag. Only sanity tests I want to execute. So whatever tests which are specified with the sanity tag, I want to execute only those tests. Okay. So then what we can do is we can run this command just by passing one option here in the documentation they clearly provided. So this is the command. So npx playwright test --grep, and here you can specify the tag name. Whichever tag you specified for the test, you can specify that. So let me slightly change the command. I can say And this is a normal way we can execute this command, right? So along with this, we can provide one more option, space --grep. And here you can specify the name of the tag. So I want to execute only sanity test. So I can say @sanity. So the tag name can be anything. It is a simple user defined. You can give any name. So --grep @sanity. Now, because of this option, what will happen? It will choose only the tests which are having sanity tag, and then it will execute. So as per my expectation, test one and test two should be executed now. Press enter. Now you can see only three got passed. So first two are sanity tests. And if I look at the last one, fifth one is also belongs to sanity tag, right? So that is also considered. So totally three tests are got executed. Test one, test five, and also test two. You can look at here. Test two, test one, and test five are executed. Okay, now let me slightly change the command. For example, I want to execute only the regression test. Let's say, what are the regression tests? Third one, and also fourth one, and even fifth one is also belongs to regression. Totally three tests are there. So slightly you can just change here, regression tag, @regression. Now this time is also executed only three tests which are belongs to regression. You can look at here, fourth one, fifth one, and third one, 3, 4, and 5. Five is again belongs to both sanity and regression, and that also executed. Okay, this is a one thing. Suppose I want to execute the test which is belongs to both sanity and regression. And how many tests we have? Only one test. Fifth one is belongs to both sanity and regression. Now I want to execute only this one. So that I can specify like this. Same command. --grep, @reg, and also @sanity. Both you can specify. Now this will go and execute this particular test, because this is the test which is belongs to both sanity and also regression, both the groups. So this will go and execute only one test, which is fifth one. Now it is successfully executed. I think it is not found any test. Okay, it is not found any test. Let me try to write one more time. Sanity @reg. And @sanity register. So fine, I don't have any issues. Okay, let me try to save the file once again and then execute. So the command is npx playwright test and tags.spec, project is Chromium, and --grep, and after that we can specify @reg and @sanity. So let me try to execute one more time. And it is saying no test found. There is some problem. Let us look at this. Okay, so the problem is whenever you are executing this command, first we specify the sanity tag and then we specify the regression tag, right? So we have to exactly specify the same thing. So if you just interchange these two values, it will not work. Okay, so I'm just changing now. Sanity and the regression tag. So this will go and execute the test. So only one test is got executed. So this is one thing. So we can execute only sanity test. Test which are belongs to sanity, we have executed. The test which are belongs to regression also we have executed. And the test which is belongs to both sanity and regression is also executed. So now my requirement is, I want to execute only sanity, which is not belongs to regression. So that means what? This test will eliminate. I want to execute only sanity test, which is not belongs to regression. If I look at this, this is a purely sanity. This is also purely sanity. But the last one, if I look at, this is belongs to both sanity and regression. But I don't want to execute this because this is also belongs to regression, right? So I want to execute only sanity, but not regression. So when you specify only sanity, here what is happening? The last test also is executing because it is also part of the sanity. But I don't want to execute this. So I want to execute only sanity, but it is part of regression that I want to eliminate. So what we can do is --grep or @sanity. And I want to eliminate regression, right? For that, you can say one more option you need to provide. --grep --invert. This is an option. So -grep @sanity, this should be included. And -grep -invert, this is excluded. Which one we have to exclude? @regression, we have to exclude. Okay, this is the command. So -grep @sanity, which should be included. All the sanity tests will be executed. And -grep -invert @regression. So regression test is excluded. Let me just run it. Yeah, now you can see two tests are executed. And test one and test two. Because only those two tests are belongs to sanity tag. And the last one is not executed because that is also part of the regression. So we have eliminated that. Same thing if you want to execute only regression but not sanity. Only regression but not sanity. Then we can just change it. So here, grep @reg, that means regression will execute. And don't want to execute the sanity. So -grep -invert, here you can say sanity. So this will execute only regression but not sanity. Now again, two tests are executed, test 3 and 4. And if I look at here, test 3 is purely related to regression tag, and which is also regression tag. And fifth one is not executed because which is belongs to sanity tag, which we have eliminated, right? So that's how we can execute the test. Whichever test you want to execute, you can just add some tags and you can refer those tags in the command line. And accordingly, we can execute whichever test you want to execute. And you can eliminate or you can avoid whatever test, simply you can avoid. So this is a simple concept of tagging. Okay. So in the next video, we will see how we can work with the annotations. So this is related to annotations concept. In the next video, we will try to discuss these annotations. Okay. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.